Welcome to Object Oriented Programming. So let's start Unit 1, that is a class and object. Myself, Dr. S. N. Gujjar, sir. I am going to teach you. We will discuss with on this class and object Unit 1. Now, hence you are going to start the C++ concept. Already you have learned C language. So that the C language content first the include file. In this include file, hash include opening curly bracket dash stdio.h, then greater than sign. So that stdio.h stand for standard input output header file. And here suppose you are going to start with the C++, that you have to include iostream.h. So input output stream dot header file. So that's what we have to include over here. Now then class declarations, you have to declare the class with the class name and opening curly bracket and closing curly bracket. So in that class you may going to declare the some function, so that is called as the member function. So what is the member? That is the member function of that class. And you have to create the object in a main function. From that object you are going to call all these classes by using object. Now see the one example. From this example you are going to easily clear how we are going to write the program. So example, display the name and the age of a person using a class. So first I am going to include here iostream.h. Suppose you are using a Turbo C++, or suppose you are using the Linux, Ubuntu or the Fedora, that time you have to only include iostream, and then you have to write using namespace standard. So this is the modification you are going to do as per the operating system. Now then I am going to declare here class. So class in a small letter, then write down the person is the name of that class, and opening curly bracket and closing curly bracket, and this you have to close the class by using a semicolon so that compiler can understand this is the class declaration. And in this class declaration, that I am going to declare the variable, the character name 30. So this is the name, opening square bracket, closing square bracket indicate the array. So character name 30, int age, integer data types, here character data types, here semicolon, that is end of the line statement. Public access specifier, that the public is that I am going to declare void get data and put data void. And here I am also using the void. Void means that returns the value 0. And here void means I am not going to pass any value inside the get data. Only I am going to read the values from the get data function. So this is the declaration of the function that we can perform in a class. Here void put data is again void I am going to use in opening bracket, closing bracket. So that indicate this void you are not going to accept any arguments over here. Close this curly bracket with the semicolon. So now void person, here I am using the scope resolution operator get data. So what is the scope resolution operator? The void person is the name of my class. From this class I have declared this the get data function with the void. So this function I am going to write the definition. Here the declaration and here the definition. When writing the definition I must use this scope resolution operator. So now opening curly bracket, see out that enter name that I am writing in a double quote, that is going to display in output screen, close by using the semicolon. See in, that is going to read the name, and that is going to store in the name integer character array. Now see out enter age, and then again see in age. This close the function here. While writing the function, opening curly bracket and closing curly bracket. Now come for the next one, void person. Here I am again using the scope resolution operator because of the put data is the function inside a class person. Now see out name and see out age. So here double quote, that is going to print in output screen, and name that I have declared as a variable. So whatever the name I will store over here, that is going to print over here. Again age, this is whatever the age I have entered from the get data, that is going to put by using a put data. Now then write the main function. The main function I have using the integer with the data types. Then person is my class name, and small p is nothing but the object. From this object I am going to call this all functions. So p is the object. So p dot get data, that is going to read the data, and p dot put data, that is going to print the data, return 0, and this is going to complete your main functions. Now what is the output is there? See, so once I have compiled this and then execute this program, so enter name xyz, enter age 20, then put the enter over here, so that is going to print the name xyz and age 20. So this is the one of the example that going to show you how going to use the scope resolution operator by using the class. Now declaration of the variable. Now how you are going to declare the variable over here? So C++ allows the declaration variable anywhere in the scope, but that is not allowed in the C. C you can declare the variable up on the main functions with the top, but here I can declare the functions int float x, float sum, and inside the loop also I can declare the variable. So that is one of the advantage of C++. So here also the declaration is possible. C in sum is equal to sum plus x, and then float average. After this also I am going to declare the average as a variable, and average sum, that I am going to perform the one operation, C out average, and then return 0. So this is the declarations of the variables. Now scope resolution operator. Suppose scope resolution operator that can be used to access the scope over here. Means how? See here. Suppose I am going to declare any variable. This is must be the global variable that can be accessed anywhere. This m is redeclared, and here again I am going to declare the m is declared again. Now we are inner the block. So what is the value of m? We are k that I have put the m. So this is the first value m, another one is scope resolution m value. See, we are in the outside the block, m value over here and scope resolution m value. Now what is the inner block k? I have already continued with the 20, means this is the main function started. M value I have initialized the k, and then I have declared the m is equal to 30. So k value is already m that I have declared, and m whatever I have declared there is, and the scope resolution operator is going to access the global variable only. Why? Because of whatever is outside the main function that I have declared globally, that is can be accessed using global variable. Again m value I have considered here, that is the 20, and the global variable m. So this is the scope resolution operator to work. Now inline functions. So what is the inline function? An inline function is a function that is expanded in a line when it is invoked. That is, the compiler replaces the function's call with the corresponding function's code. So the inline function defined as follows: inline function header name and function body. Now how? See the one example. From this example you are easily understood how we are going to use the inline function. Hash include outstream.h, inline float multiple float x float y, return x multiplied by y. So inline function double division, double p q, and that I have divided into. Now in the main function float a, that I have declared b value, c out multiple a b, and c out a d division. See, this has become the output of the inline functions. Now the function overloading. The function overloading means, for suppose the same functions I am going to call with the different parameters, and not only the different parameter, the data types of the parameters again I am going to change. So that nothing but the function overloading. Overloading refers to the use of the same things for different purposes. So we can use the same function's name to create the function that perform the variety of the different tasks. So how we are going to declare? See, the int, int ab. Here I have used the same add is the function name, but the parameter here 2 I am passing, here parameter 3 is passing. So this function add is going to overloaded. Now the integer data types I have used here is the double data types I have used, but here double x, double y, double p, int, q I am using. So again the function name is the same, that is add function is going to overloaded. Then function call. How the function call is going to done? Suppose I am going to call in the two parameter function, that is going to call this one. Suppose the three parameter, this three parameter with the double three parameter, so double three and double two, the double two parameter, right? This integer. So this is the function call. Now specifying the classes. Suppose I am in the class name private and public. So suppose I am using the public variable declaration, function declarations over here. So suppose p dot x I am going to use, x, y, z, p that I have created, p dot x, that the x class I have created, but this is in my protected mode, so you cannot going to use over here directly, but those are I am using the public mode that you can use. Okay, so this is just specifying the function. Now, the next lecture we are going to start with the friend function.